meant transparent. Yikes. Hello, welcome. I'm Midnight. Today I will be explaining the settings window for VMagic Mirror version 1.4.0. I began using this program in my streams, and as a newcomer to VTubing, I believe it's a great program for anyone looking for a free, easy to use face tracking software to begin VTubing. This video is part of a series I'll be making to cover all components in VMagic Mirror. Today, I will break down the settings window and explain how to optimize window settings, create natural lifelike motion, adjust your avatar's layout, add special effects, and create custom facial expressions. If you'd like to learn more about me, you can follow me on my social media accounts linked in the description, or come hang out with me on my Twitch streams. Remember, a link to VMagic Mirror will be in the description box. If you haven't watched part 1, make sure to check it out, linked below. Please remember to save your settings or all your hard work will go to waste. One more thing before we begin, there is a lot of redundancy throughout these settings, so I will be skipping anything that I mentioned in the previous video. Now let's begin. First, let's optimize the window settings. Background. Choose a color you prefer. I personally don't like the bright green you start off with, so I searched Google for an RGB color picker. When you find a color you like, you can set the sliders accordingly. I've already mentioned this in the previous video, but to go a bit more in depth, and for anyone who hasn't watched part 1 of the series, I will reiterate myself. If you'd like to set the window to be transparent, you can do so here. To drag your avatar while the window is transparent, you can check this box. Then you can drag your avatar around the screen. You might want to turn this off after you've adjusted your avatar to your preferred position on the screen. If you'll be playing a game of, say, League of Legends that requires sporadic clicking, as you could accidentally move your avatar. Always foreground will place your avatar in front of other windows. Note, this will not work on applications that are set to full screen unless they are windowed. If you'd like to know how to set your game to windowed mode, check my previous video linked in the description box. I covered virtual camera output in my previous video as well. There are different transparency levels that can help you navigate around your avatar. I've broken them down in a table for you. Essentially, level 0 is always visible. Level 1 is by default always visible, invisible only when your cursor is over your avatar and drag character is off. Level 2 is by default always visible and always invisible when your cursor is over your avatar. Level 3 is always visible when drag character is on, always invisible when drag character is off, and level 4 is always invisible. I think I meant transparent. Yikes. I always keep this at level 2 when watching this video and my previous video. I am referring to transparency level 2. Alpha 1 transparent is the level of transparency when your avatar is transparent. I set this to transparency level 4 while adjusting the transparency on my avatar. Then I can switch back to level 2. So when I hover over my avatar, you can see the transparency. Next, we'll cover creating natural lifelike motion in your avatar. Upper body, always hands down mode, is pretty self-explanatory, so I'll skip over that. For lip sync, make sure to set your microphone. Face tracking, make sure to set your webcam. For face tracking, make sure you're sitting up straight and calibrate your position. Hand tracking, enable image-based hand tracking, allows you to track your hands. Moving your left hand will move her left hand. Moving your right hand will move her right hand. Therefore, I think it is important to match this by disabling the horizontal flip. If auto blink is asymmetrical, as it is in my case, you should enable auto blink. Winking is not possible in my case. Again, this might simply be due to my lighting. You can enable forward backward motion. This is too glitchy for me. Could be due to my lighting. So I prefer to leave it off. Just be sure to have good lighting for face tracking and let me know if these work for you in the comments below or if you have any tips you can share. I would also suggest turning on blink adjust by head and lip sync, as well as voice-based motion when webcam is not being used. What this will do is cause your avatar to blink based on head motion, and when you're not using your webcam, your avatar will move based on your voice input. Eye look target was also covered in part 1. Eye motion scale is a percentage your avatar's bones will move. I keep them at 100 as this looks more natural. But you can increase this dramatically if you'd like. Fun blend makes her smile by default. I'm not too sure how to customize the eyebrows at the moment. Please share any info you have in the comments below. If you can enable, disable typing and mouse motion. I don't recommend typing passwords ever if, say, you're streaming or recording videos, but just in case, it is a good idea to enable random typing to hide key input, especially if you'll be using facial expressions, which I'll get to more later in the video. If you notice that your avatar looks a bit off, in this next section, you'll be able to adjust your avatar's position to look more natural. You can modify your avatar's shoulder motion. Play with the waist width and strength to keep upper arm to body until you like the position. Waist width increasing this slider will cause her elbows to fan outward. Strength to keep upper arm to body increasing this slider will cause her elbows to be pulled in closer to her body. Mousing over, enable mouse motion to FPS mode. Reads, when checked, right hand motion during FPS games becomes more natural, but touchscreen or pen tablet operation becomes slower. Presentation like hand makes her point in the direction of your cursor with her right hand. You can also add a ring around your cursor to make it easily visible. You can adjust it by using the sliders below. Adjusting the position of her hands relative to her keyboard slash mouse pad can be done here in the hand section. Weight motion. Weight motion simulates breathing. Scale determines the depth of her breaths. While period determines the rate at which she breathes at. The longer it takes for her to take a breath, the slower she's breathing. So the longer in seconds. I prefer to just keep these at their default settings, but just make sure to enable it. Third, adjusting your avatar's layout, starting with camera. Set to free camera mode to adjust the position of the camera. FOV degrees is essentially your zoom in and out. For a more detailed explanation on this, see part 1. Again, be careful not to overwrite your camera settings. Devices. To adjust the keyboard and mouse pad, select free layout. Use position to change the object's position in the X, Y, and Z planes. For rotational motion, use the rotational control. You have the freedom to scale the objects as well if you so desire. When you're done, make sure to close out the free layout. For keyboard and touchpad, you can choose to disable their visibility. Use MIDI controller for VMagic Mirror, MIDI controller visibility, and you can add typing effects. I'll mention the gamepad in a separate video as I have not tried this yet. Effects. Moving on to adding special effects. Choose your image quality. If you begin to lag, you may want to reduce this. This may remove some effects, notice the shadow disappearing. But a smooth stream is better than one that is dropping frames, so just keep that in mind. Choose the color of light you want on your avatar. Remember, you can always Google RGB color picker to help you find the correct values for the desired color. The intensity is exactly what it means. It is essentially the brightness of the light source. You can change the yaw or pitch angle of the light source as well. Enable shadows so your avatar will have a shadow, and adjust the intensity, yaw, and pitch angles, and also the depth offset. Adding bloom to your avatar creates a glowing effect. You may also want to have wind enabled. I think this would look really cute on an elf or Elderwood Ahri, for example, with a nice fantasy background. But otherwise, I prefer to leave this off. You're free to tinker with the strength, fineness, and direction of the wind. And finally, the ABC Expressions tab. Here you can choose what device to assign facial expressions to. At the moment, I have mine set to keyboard, though there are a few different options. Though this does create a problem when typing numbers, as you can see my avatar's random facial expressions become activated whenever I type numbers. To view a facial expression, hit the play button, or in my case, I can hit the numbers 0 through 8. To edit a particular facial expression, hit the gear. This will open a new window with a variety of different options. There are a couple of built-in motions, which are by default pre-assigned to certain commands. Make sure Enable Face Expression is enabled if you are to use a corresponding facial expression along with emotion. You can choose the duration of the body motion, or you can type it in on the side. If you'd rather this cause your avatar to keep the facial expression until another is activated, other than the default resting face expression, you can choose to keep the face expression after the motion. To allow your avatar's mouth movement to continue during the facial expression, check Keep Lip Sync Active box. Note, certain facial expressions with wide mouths will cause warping of your face, such as joy. You may want to tone down the facial expression if you are to allow lip sync, or just turn it off entirely. Basic blend shape gives you a variety of different facial expressions to choose from. You can play around with it and see what you'd like. You can rename your facial expression. Hit OK when you're happy with the facial expression. And you will see it renamed there. If instead you'd like to add another facial expression, hit this plus button and you'll see another facial expression pop up here that you can edit. If you have any further questions, please leave a comment below. Otherwise, I'll see you next time. Thank you for watching and don't forget to like. Bye! You can enable or disable typing and mouse motion. So I am typing and she is not. Oh. Never mind. Wait, what? Okay, anyway. Oh!